Hi, I'm Oscar Brown Jr. on the Jazz Scene USA. Tonight we're really cooking, serving up a delightful dish named Nancy Wilson, one of those happy blends of talent, beauty, taste, and sensitivity. Ah, but why take my word for it? Sample for yourself as our happy blend serves up some happy talk.
Keep talking a happy talk. Talk about things you'd like to do. You gotta have a dream. If you don't have a dream, how you gonna have a dream come true? Whoa. Talk about the moon in the sky, looking like a lily on a lake. Talk about the bird.
Discovered America. In 1952, Columbus, Ohio discovered Nancy Wilson. Nancy had done a lot of singing in churches around Columbus, and that year she was elected by her high school to enter a citywide talent contest. But when the contest officials heard Nancy sing, they decided she was so good there'd be no competition if she remained in the running. So Nancy was pulled out of the contest and put on TV instead. A 13-week television series was created for 15-year-old Nancy Wilson, its star. After high school, Nancy spent a year at Central State College in Ohio, but decided there was much more for her to learn, singing with various bands, playing weekend engagements around the state. What did this higher education teach her? Well, probably the most important lesson was respect for lyrics. Singing a song is telling a story. That means the singer must select material that has something valid to say and then say it with understanding and conviction. Nancy learned her lesson well. Listen as she applies her studies to become Little Girl Blue.
When I was very young, the world was younger than I. As merry as a carousel, the circus tent was strung with every star in the sky. Above the ring I knew so well. Now the young world has gone are the tinsel and gold. sit there and count your fingers. What can you do?
Sunshine all over the place. Just put on a hat.
get a happy, a be a happy, get happy, a be happy.
Broadway musicals. For a singer like Nancy Wilson, who believes in telling a story, they're a rich source of material. Of course, presented by a jazz-oriented artist like Nancy, these selections swing a lot more or are much more bluesy than in their original Broadway form. But the message, the story is still there. And for many, it has more meaning than ever. Nancy's style complements Broadway's best. Cannonball Adderley was quick to spot this when Nancy moved to New York in 1959. He started Wheels Turning, which led to a Capitol recording contract for Nancy, and one beautiful result of that was this album. Now Nancy is going to sing a selection from the album. It's Frank Lesser's Never Will I Marry from his musical, Green Willow. After that wonderful rendition, most of our audience is convinced you're a confirmed bachelor girl.
Most people usually think so after that, but it is not so. Actually, I'm married, and he's to a very wonderful fellow, really.
Yeah, who is also a very talented musician in his own right. Kenny Dennis, the drummer in this swinging trio that's accompanying Nancy. Kenny, come on in and join us, won't you?
Hello,
how you
Oscar.
Doing?
Yeah. Hi, honey.
Hello,
meet Mr. and Mrs. Kenneth C. Dennis. Now, how about you introducing the rest of the fellows in the trio?
Yes, Oscar. That's Lou Levy at the piano. Incidentally, Oscar,
yes.
Lou Levy's fine work can be heard on Nancy's Hello, Young Lovers album.
Wow.
Another outstanding musician, the one and only Al McKibbon on bass.
You're sounding wonderful, fellas.
Thank you.
Nancy, so much of your material comes from Broadway. I sense that you're headed in that direction, right?
I'm hoping to. I have plans for next year, what we're studying over the winter time, and hoping that legitimate theater will open up next year, within the next 2 years anyway. I have my fingers and
okay, we all do. What are you going to sing for us next?
Right now, I'd like to do a tune for you called Guess Who I Saw Today.
Another wonderful show tune. Kenny, while you get set on the drums, let me try and set the scene for this number.
Sure, thank you. Excuse me.
We're in the living room of a comfortable suburban home. The husband has just come home from work, removed his hat, and settled in his chair with the paper.
You're so late getting home from the office. Did you miss your train? Maybe we're caught in the rain. No, don't bother to explain. Can I fix you a quick martini? As a matter of fact, I'll have one with you. For to tell you the truth, I've had quite a day to. Shop around for something new, and thought I'd stop and have a bite when I was through. I looked around for some place near, and it occurred to me where I had parked the car. Was a most attractive French cafe and bar. It really wasn't very far. The waiter showed me to a dark, secluded corner, and as my eyes became accustomed, two people at the bar who were so in love, even I could spot it clear across the room. Guess who I saw today, my dear? I've never been so shocked before. I headed blindly. Guess who I saw today? Guess who I saw today? Guess who I saw?
Nancy Wilson and Frank Lesser have never met face to face, but the singer and the composer have had many happy meetings in music. Here's one now as Nancy closes with Frank's I Believe in You.
You have the cool. Loud and clear, yet there's that bold phrase. that slam bang. Tang, reminiscent of gin and vermouth. I believe in you. I believe in you. And though in my fate and my fellow man are all but falls apart, I but to feel your hand grasping mine, and I take heart, I take heart to feel the cool.
Wonderful Nancy Wilson for singing, and to you for listening and watching. Oscar Brown Jr., later.